Think about the place where you live. What does the land look like? Are there tall mountains nearby? Or is the land so flat that you can see for miles? Which picture looks more like Indiana, where we live? The first one? The top left? Or the bottom one? Bottom right. Is it a desert where there are sand and cacti? Or is it covered with green grasses and trees? If you guessed the green grasses and trees, of course, you'd be correct. Indiana was flattened by a glacier during the Ice Age, so the majority is flat and has deciduous trees, or leaved trees, and grasses. Now think about the weather. What is it like? Does it get really hot in the summer? Do you see snow in the winter? How much does it rain? Do tornadoes ever strike? Finally, think about the people who live in your city. Do they mostly live in apartments and houses? Do the people use cars or buses to get around? Or do they use subway trains? The things that I just had you think about are part of the areas called geography. Geography is the word of the day. Geography is the study of the world, its people, and the human and physical features or the landscapes that make it different or unique. So, what do geographers do all day? Many of the questions the geographers ask deal with how the world works. They want to know how mountains are formed and what created that tornado. Geographers gather data or information and then study it carefully before they can learn what that information means. Geographers are adventurers. They are constantly asking questions. They want to travel and figure things out. Does that maybe sound like you? Maybe you will be a geographer someday. Let's look at a short video clip from an actual geographer, Karen Joyce, to see what she, as a professional, does all day as a geographer. When we lived in caves, there were no, that's the barter system. We're going to get to that in just a minute. All right, Miss Karen. So let's go back to the presentation. My network is lagging a little bit, but it'll be fine. All right, so that's just a little bit of a snippet of what a geographer does throughout their careers. Whether a geographer studies volcanoes and storms or people in cities, they have to look carefully. That's the key. They're very detail-oriented. They're adventurers, but they also have a lot of detail. They look at the world around them. They typically look at the places at three levels. The first one is the local level. The local level is the smallest. It is typically a town or a city and focuses in on one area. Next, the second level is the regional level. Sometimes geographers want a bigger data set or a bigger chunk of the world they study. A region is a part of the world that has one or more common features that distinguish it from surrounding areas. An example of this would be a Rocky Mountain range. That's on the west side, the western area of the United States. The Rocky Mountain region covers more than 3,000 miles and runs through the states of Colorado, Nevada, Wyoming, Idaho, and Montana. And the third level, that's the global level. So we have local, regional, global. So we're getting bigger. And global is just like it sounds. It's a global. Geographers want to gather data from around the world to see how things interact globally. So a common example of this is trade or bartering of goods, which you saw, I have a little bit of a snippet of a video on that. But trade or bartering is when they trade things for how we've developed our money system. And geographers examine a product that one could export and then see how those products can be used in other countries. Through this data collection, geographers have determined that our money has developed over the years into an exchange system. So now, let's go back over to the barter video. This is the one I accidentally brought up to begin with, and see how that works. This is from Schoolhouse Rock. Malls, people's manners were Neanderthal. No bodegas, no delis, no corner stores. Shopping trips turned into tugs of war. When not having pool got this man mangled, he thought he'd try an easier angle. I'll give you this for that, that for this. We'll make a trade called barter. I'll give you this for that, that for this. We'll have it made with barter. Barter worked well, at least in theory, but a wallet full of yaks could make you weary. Making change for a cow wasn't easy to master unless you were ready for an utter disaster. Shiny shells were far more portable. Why not use them for what's affordable? I'll give you this for that, that for this. With shiny shells, why barter? I'll give you this for that, that for this. Shelling out shells is smarter. For farmers in ancient Mesopotamia, the barley they grew was the money mania. When hauling big sacks put their backs in traction, they invented coins to lighten transactions. Now when a man had a debt to settle, he'd dig out some coins made of precious metal. This for that, that for this, silver or gold or copper. I'll give you this for that, that for this, with coins you're a smarter shopper. Then China made money even more desirous, printing it on paper made of crushed papyrus. Take one from column A and one from column B, the Chinese paid their checks in paper currency. When Columbus set out on that famous charter, he had no paper money, so he had to barter. He took along some beads for currency, so barter played a part in our discovery. Balboa and Pizarro and Sebastian Cabot, even Coronado had the trading habit. I'll give you this for that, that for this. They loaded up with gold and parted. I'll give you this for that, that for this. And soon the whole world was charted. Today we use cash and spend with ardor, but that doesn't mean we don't still barter. When a football team needs an all-pro guard, or a kid like you is into trading cards, take this for that, that for
Bills and coins are smarter, but when you pay for that, remember this, it all started out with barter.
Right, so let's go back to our presentation. And sorry about if you heard the dog barking in the background there. All right, so let's review. What is geography? Make sure you know that for the quiz. What is the landscape? Be able to list two ways a geographer could gather data. Be able to name the three levels of looking at the world and tell me the difference between the three. So the local, the regional, the global, the different levels. Make sure you can tell me the difference between the two. And be able to list two ways to identify Indiana's landscape, specifically Indiana. And understand what trade means. That was that last video, trade and bartering, and why geographers might study that. Why is it important? Why would they study that? Good luck.